Great. There it goes. Great here. Welcome back to Factorio. Sometimes DXStory loves to do a little false start. What can I say? So, we have a ton of things in here. We have a whole bunch. Well, no, we don't have any in there. Do we have... How much of this do we have in the... Only seven. But we have a bunch of purple science. I mean, look at the glorious purple science. Excellent. I wonder if I should, extend this so I can speed up my science research. Maybe. Sure, why not? That's what robots are for. Now let's just get rid of these parts right here. Okay. And I'm going to have to... Why did this not take? You kill the trees. We're going to have to extend the walls. This is kind of an on-the-whim thing, so... But this is exactly what robots make possible. Why I pushed for them all those episodes ago is just stuff like this. Let's see... Oh, let's just make it easy. Except I placed it backwards. I know, all of you caught it. I didn't. Shush. There. And, yes, it bugs me this much. I'm gonna do it. That way the wires go correct, are correct. Let's just put one more right there. Okay. We need to get... Do I have medium poles in here? Yes. Okay, so let's put the medium poles back here. Get these started up. And how many do I want to add? 1, 2, 3, 4. Let's see if I can add another 8. Let's see. Oh, I didn't get the inserters on the outside. Whoops. Yeah. I don't know if my production can support this, but I'm going to do it. And let's put this laser turret right here, facing outward. That way I can sneak this through here. There we go. And... Get these. Oh, come on. There. And there goes all of the science. Perfect. Oh, and it drained all of this. Ooh. And of course, if I check my logistics network, God, these cables. Just ignore the cables, they don't exist. If I check the logistics network, I know there's science in there somewhere. So what we really should do is let's get two requester chests here and here. And this one will request red science in case any of it ever gets into the network. And this one will request green science in case any of it gets in the network. Then we need basically the same thing here. So let's get another requester chest here. And this will be for purple science. And now we need to find a way to get blue science onto the belt. Right here. Requester chest. No, but it needs to... It needs to be on this side. Oh, I know what I can do. Right there. No. I can't, because it... Why you gotta be like this? Why? Okay, it'll just have to be here then. Right there. And this will be for any blue science that got caught up in the logistics network. That should work. Yeah, there's some blue science. Right there. Oh no, yeah, no. That's from these waiting. Oops. Okay, maybe it all... Did it all go onto me? Oh, I guess it all went onto me. Well, let's just, dump it in random, yeah. There you go. Have free science. Okay, well, that isn't what I had planned. I actually didn't have anything planned. I am just trying to figure out what I want to do next. I think I actually, if I remember correctly, I wanted to do chest construction over here. I believe that was the next thing I wanted to do. Because I no longer want to have to... I want to be able to place these chests automatically in builds. They all need electric circuits, advanced circuits, and steel chests. So I need steel to come up. And in fact, what's the ratio? Steel chest is 8 steel plates. So let's build one of steel and a hybrid of red and blue circuits. That sounds good. And so there's our steel line. Of course I'm not building these correctly. There we go. And to there. And up, and I need more underground belt because I'm not making that automatically yet. I mean, I wouldn't be able to request it even if I were building it automatically, so it's fine. Okay. Now we need a hybrid of green and red. Well, the green is going to be easy. Let's just do a split right here. And I'm out of splitters. And then a splitter like this. Here, so I can route this back down this way. And I believe if I put that, if I put it like this, I can, there, get half belts on either side in a relatively compact form. Now, I'm going to want to bend this over and then back up. Like so. And just extend these out. All the way up to here. Actually, no, that's not what I want to do. I want this to end. And I need an assembly machine here. This assembly machine is going to make my steel chests. And just output it right back to this side. And the steel chest will continue on like so. Let's get five assembly machine twos. And okay, so we have storage chests, requester chest. Okay, this is going to be storage chests. This will be my passive provider. This is going to be the active provider. This is going to be the requester. There we go. Little alien attack going on there. And each of these is going to drop into a passive provider chest. And I'm going to need four long-handed inserters for this build. Okay. Gun turret damage 3 has been researched. What do I want next? Effects. This is piercing shotgun shells. Interesting. But no. Let's get... I don't know if I want to go jumping into purple science. Inserter, capacitor, stack inserter. I'm still not using any stack inserters, so... Let's crank out this tiny thing to get it out of the way. Okay, so on this side, we need two inserters here. And then we're going to need the long-handed inserters over here. Like so. Except I think... Yeah, I done goofed. Let's switch these two around. I think... This will work. Like so. You know what I'm going to do? I'm going to do the same thing that I did before. There we go. That way, it's not just, you know, sitting on the north side, and this, whatever. Okay, so, medium, medium, and medium. Go, go, go. Okay, logistics 3 would be interesting, concrete would be interesting. So concrete is like the brick, except you use brick, iron ore, and 10 water, and you lay this out like brick, and you run faster than if you're on brick, which I am not interested in right now. Let's get accumulators out of the way. Okay, so let's restrict all of these to one slot. I'm not in any way interested in having more than 50 of any of these ever. And if they get it, I'm not even going to restrict them on the logistics network. There's just no need for it. I don't want... actually, what I should do is get another blueprint. Thank you. I keep adding a new blueprint when I've got one in here. So let's just grab that. There we go. Because I'm going to make this... I'm going to basically specify, hey, if you want... this path is here to say, by the way, if you want chests, come up this path here. Yeah, see, this is why I'm doing this, because this guy would never get anything. Even then, he's not. So... Well, first off, this guy should be a fast inserter. That's all there is to it. Yeah. And then this guy can actually output here. Okay, so passive. Actually, I'm going to change this. I want to be active. No, storage chest. I want to be active chess. Okay, the reason for that is because the requesters and the passive providers are the ones I use the most. I want them to have priority on this rigmarole. And in fact, I can have this turn a little bit sooner. Okay. And this doesn't have to go near. Oh, does need to go up to that, to there, however. And is this? Yeah, this is still waiting. So, there we go. Let's really just crank those out. And now I just need to clear all these chests. Which is fine. Yeah, 29 active provider chests. I didn't need those already. So you can go back in there. I'm going to use you. I'm going to use you. And I'm definitely going to use you. Good deal. Okay. Energy distribution. This gets us our substations. Yes. Okay. So that's definitely going to nibble through my steel backlog. Let's go take a look at our steel production all the way back here. I mean, this factory is getting pretty nice. It's getting pretty lengthy. It's nothing like some of the factories I've seen in other Let's Plays, but it's getting there. Okay. And how's our water situation? Ooh. Am I back to the point where, yeah, I need more solar production because I'm not getting the hot water stores for the overnight. There they are. Okay. And let's go back over here, as this is where we are making our solar array. God, I will be so happy when all that coal is gone. Let's just cram this in here. And the other technology that I got, which was the landfill. The landfill allows me to just fill in this water area here with the use of stone. However, it's not something I'm interested in, really. Okay. I'm going to leave a little path in here to that that RoboPort in case I need to get in there to do whatever. And There we go. That's... I think that'll be good enough for now. Yeah, because here we are. We've run out of hot water, you can tell. All these engines are going full speed. Yeah, see? And the factory just goes to a crawl because I don't have my hot water. What's missing? 7 materials for construction. Okay, that's fine. Those will be made as time goes by. Now let's look at our power again. Okay, so... it looks like we're coming up to about... we'll call it 25 megawatts. And we've got 30 in steam engines. So we need to get 30 in solar panels. Which, 60 kilowatts is what, 500 solar panels, maybe? Don't math while doing Let's Plays. It never ends well. Yeah, it looks like... yeah, I gotta be up. I'm way behind on my solar panels. Where's my solar panel production? There it is. Yeah, this is going as pretty much as fast as it can. Well, it could be a bit faster. And, yeah, that steel is just getting gobbled up over here. But once these get maxed out, they will definitely... the steel will back up. Okay. There's our substations. Let's go for... oh, auto trash. Yes, please. Let's get over to our speed modules. Grab all of those. And now we can make a few more of our assembling machine 3s. And what do I want to increase? I definitely want to increase the speed of my solar panels. I'm not worried about the increased speed of roboports. Need to look around on this. Oh, I know where we could use a bit more. All the way back at the beginning, the green circuit production at the beginning of the bus. Right here. This could use a bit more speed. And in fact, I bet you if I made all of these fast inserters... we'll definitely get more production out of it. And let's double this up for the iron and the copper wire. There we go. Of course, I'll probably have to do the same thing on the other end of the bus. How's our logistics robots? We're up to about 50 or 60 in use at any given time. Yeah, these are all slow again, so let's get a bunch more of our fast inserters. And... oh, I'd already doubled these up for the iron and the wire. I guess it's fine that I'm merging these in here. Okay, let's look at this real quick. This gets merged in here. And I primarily want to feed this. What I can do, however, is come back this way. And let's get rid of this electric circuit bleed into the logistics network. Let's look at our power now that it's getting nighttime again. Okay, looks like we're doing okay. So what I can do is now, somewhere after this merge point is where I can put in my green circuit bleed. In fact, this looks like a good spot right here just to bleed off circuits. It's near the end of the bus. These do get pulled off every once in a while, but not often. So let's go there. Let's get a passive provider chest up here. And let's get this connected to the logistics network and tow it. Green circuits. Green circuits. If you have less than 500 in the logistics network, grab. And then I'm going to give it all of those. There we go. Of course, now whenever the logistics the logistics bots need to bring me circuits, now they got to come all the way over here. But yeah, it's worth it. And can I get power armor? Yes, I can, which requires 10 alien artifacts. Yeah, let's go up to power armor. And on that note, I'm going to have to put a cut in here. Hope you enjoyed today's video, and have fun.